Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari, back once more. Let's hope to stay, at least for this series, and I have some other stuff in the works. Wow, zero rations, that's no good. Anyway, we're back here. There's an orb, right? There's an orb with a skull inside or something like that. Yeah, a sphere. Inside the sphere is bone. Yeah. And Zob didn't work. So we're here in the, what they call the College of Magic over here on the... I guess this would be... I don't even know, because things move around. Looks like it would be the western side of this whole area, Mampang. Just trying to explore the rest of this before we head up to our ultimate destination, I guess. I'm not even sure which of these I have been to and which I have not. Pretty sure I haven't been to this, and then we could cross over to this. I think we've been here, and I'm assuming we can just leave. I think this is the one with the statues in it. That are not statues, but actually corpses. Yeah, it was fun. Anyway, casting a spell, because we're going to try to cast Resurrection. I got three votes for Resurrection. Oh, my throat's a little dry. One vote to save the holy water, which you need in order to cast Resurrection. So we're going to cast Resurrection, see if this skull comes alive. I've been gone for quite a while, so... It's good to be back. You take the vial of holy water from your pack and cast your spell. The water begins to shimmer and shine with an inner light. Okay. Yeah, we're not going to drink the holy water. That would give us... If we drink the holy water, it would give us, like, I think a point or two of hit points. If you guys can see this down here, I don't know why that's blinking again. We're going to pour the holy water on the sphere. You pour the sparkling water over the sphere. For a moment, you seem to hear some kind of response from inside, but it is muffled by the metal, and you can make nothing of it out. Muffled by the metal. So it's trying to talk. Mort is trying to communicate with us from Planescape Torment. Do we have something we can get rid of metal? I don't think there's anything else that we could actually use here. Sense danger. How much stamina do I have? I have some. 13 out of 27. Not so much I want to sense danger, I want to know what to do. Sharpen blade, yeah, it's not gonna... Doesn't apply. Talk with animals. Is it an animal? There are no creatures to talk to, so the spell has no effect. For all I know, I've cast this stuff already. It's been over a month since I played this. Probably about just under 2 months. Let's see the future. I know we did that. Layout. We'll do layout. Summon a giant. That's not going to help us with anything. I hate when this thing flips around like this. That's lightning, that's not gonna help. The Zob we tried. We're missing a reagent we need for that, and we don't even know what it does. That spell. are the REs now? What's Raz again? Raz is talking with animals. We're shopping late. Yeah, I'm out. I'm out of ideas. What's this paint? Oh, that's the end. Yeah, maybe it's Yob we're Zob we're supposed to cast here. But we're missing whatever we need to make that work. Alright. Leaving the tower. Okay. As you turn to go, a voice intones in your head. 3. Who's there? Your question is met by nothing but silence. Should I try to cast Resurrection 3 times? That's the only thing I'm getting from this 3. Otherwise I might have to do with those glyphs. Alright, I don't have the holy water now. Okay, the glyphs is telling me 3 now. So, what do we got? Inner vault requires a secret word. Glyph... Oh! I don't have glyph 3. I don't know, I suppose that has to do with this. To open door spell of invisibility. I mean, other than blindly casting spells, I don't want to waste a summon giant spell. How many giant teeth do I have? Do I have giant teeth? Ten giants? When the hell did I pick up 10 giants teeth? Seriously? I guess I bought all those? When I was buying teeth? If I cast it in here though, it's gonna kill me. I'm gonna get squished by the giant inside the tower. Yeah, I have no idea. I don't have the glyph for 3. I guess that's a clue. I'm not casting lightning in here. What's Yob again? Yeah, that's we're not doing that. This is the talk with animals. Yeah. We wasted it, guys. We wasted our holy water. Unless that really is it, you're supposed to cast Resurrect 3 times. I don't think I've ever had 3 quantities of holy water at once. So we're gonna leave the tower again. You turn and head quickly back out of the tower. No voice sounds in your mind this time. Oh well. You step back onto the path and follow it a short way. The early morning sun makes the air glow. Alright, let's try this, because I don't think we've been to this one. You enter the next tower. This chamber is empty save for a few crates stacked against one wall. Thick dust covers the floor, with no footprints visible. A storeroom? You step into the room, kicking up a small cloud of dust as you walk. The air inside is shimmering. Then suddenly you are blinded by a dazzling glare. Darkness spell? Not the option yet. Shield my eyes. I don't see why I would stare into the light. You shield your eyes, fearing attack, but instead a calm voice declares, "Do not fear me. You have nothing to fear. You are welcome." The voice is lilting, beautiful, calm, familiar. "My friend," the voice continues, "surely you know me." And then you know her voice, and you fall to your knees. "Libra!" "Yes, I am Libra," she replies. "I have come again to help you, but at great risk. We must speak quickly, and then you must go." I see no reason to attack Libra. But I hope it really is Libra. Libra's warmth overtakes you. You feel truly safe, at least for the moment. She senses your need and smiles. "What do you need of me?" she asks. "Can you aid me?" you ask pitifully. She nods. "I am able to transform something you own into an item of truly powerful magic, powerful enough to overcome whatever you face." Is such a thing possible? You mortals seek to dissect magic, but there is far more to it than you could ever learn. But of course. You hand over the orb of crystal. Ah! I didn't know it would be that. I mean, I guess it's okay. Which is swallowed up by the shining presence. The light streaming from Libra intensifies, blinding you for a moment. Was Libra always so bright? How about not bask in the, how about not open my eyes and make myself blind? Let's bask in the light. You bask in the light of the goddess for a moment, feeling quite sure it is flooding your bones and making you stronger. Then, when your sight returns, you see that Libra is gone. Wait. You wait. From behind you, you hear a door opening and slamming shut once more. Did she take my orb of crystal? Turn around. You turn around, but the room you are in is now entirely empty except for a discarded blonde wig. There is nothing else to do here. You leave, with a strong sense you have been tricked. Wait. I can't take the blonde wig? Okay, someone masquerading as Libra with a blonde wig. Damn you. Yeah, I don't have the Orb of Crystal. Okay. Unless I'm missing something. Well, that sucks. Alright. You race over to the next tower before the wind can pluck you from the walkway. The air moves a little around you, still icy, but fresh. As you enter the tower, five other figures step in from identical-looking doors placed evenly around the walls. Mirror image. You watch the newcomers from the safety of the doorway, and mostly they do the same, but one rushes quickly across the room and another lifts her hand and calls out a greeting. Return the greeting. You return the greeting of the stranger who spoke. One of the others rushes away through a far door. Two others cross into the middle of the room. Clone the caster. I don't know what that is. I don't have the thing to create explosions with. Cause depression, I don't see why. Light spell. Yeah, I just looked at that. Lightning. Teleportation. That's it for that. Cause fear. Summon replica creature requires a gold-back mirror. Fortunately, we don't. counters 6. 6 has cloned the caster. I'm pretty sure it is. I don't have my notes. My notes are out of reach. I'm pretty sure it is. Yeah, how about I just cross the room? From the outside, you saw clearly this tower only had 2 doorways, so you head directly forwards, aiming for the door on the other side. One other does the same, while 3 stay put, looking this way and that. The last stranger calls out a greeting. Several of the other figures in the room have begun crafting spells, and a moment later, everything goes crazy. Lightning bolts fire from one figure at another, who is wearing a black face mask. Blinding light comes from the hands of one who stands opposite, while you are suddenly feeling very depressed. One disappears completely. I'm feeling depressed. Okay, cause depression, and they're throwing zap spells at each other. Call for order? You call out for order, but the figures are too busy with their own squabbles. One has fallen to the floor in sobbing despair, while another has blown herself up with a pebble. A pop spell. Okay, leave by the far door. You head quickly across the room, but the one with the face mask turns and frightens you back. Fear spell. You hurry from the insanity of the room just as one of the figures tosses a glowing pebble at your feet, which explodes on the ground, sending stone fragments in all directions. You escape without serious injury. Okay. Oh, so we have to retreat. We can't go forward. You move along the next walkway to the tower beyond. The chamber inside is empty now. You hurry onwards. I think we've been in this one, so I'm gonna skip. I'm just gonna leave, actually. We don't have the mirror required for this. We could clone the caster. I mean, I have stuff. I don't know why. I don't like looking through here. There's too many. Yeah, I was right. The 6th spell is... Yeah, we want to counter that, but I can't. I don't have the mirror. The gold back mirror. So let's just head west. Did I see this one? A few clouds drift across the sky. You approach the next tower boldly. A gloomy silence descends. The outside of the tower is overgrown, and inside the foliage is thicker still. The floor and walls are thick with plants, and the plants themselves are dripping with overripe berries. Purple liquid pools across the stone, and a purple fog rises up from it. Smell the fog? You sniff the fog tentatively. The smell is overly sweet, almost rotten. It makes you gag slightly. Look for doors. Peering across the miniature jungle and through the haze, you can make out another door across the room. Across the room. You take a few steps further into the tower. Each footstep crushes plants and berries underfoot, staining your heels and sending up new clouds of purple fog. The sweet smell grows more cloying as you go. The plants get deeper farther in. Yeah, I'm not sure about that. I don't think we've been to this one. You keep on through the thickening foliage. Bushes grow up from cracks in the stone on all sides and hang down in vines and creepers from the ceiling. Dim light gently fills the room, though it hardly seems enough for so much growth. You are now in the middle of the tower, where the purple fog is at its thickest. You lean down and look through the bushes to the stone floor below. The plants seem to be growing in little or no soil, sustained by some magic. Your fingers move across a scratch in the ground. The mark is a single scratched line, but clearly carved. There is nothing else in the stone nearby. You take a deep breath in, taking... Ooh, we got stamina! Taking the fog into your nose and mouth, you start to feel much better. Breathe deeply again. You take another deep breath, but this time you do not feel much better for it, and the smell starts to churn your stomach somewhat. You stamp and squelch to the far side of the tower. Nothing untoward occurs. The bushes thin out once more there to doors, and fresh air beckons. Your clues have been updated. What's been updated? I don't even know. Sands of Death? Yeah, I don't see anything in it. You got me. All right. All right, we can only head south, even though it doesn't look like south. As the morning moves on, the wind begins to rise. You cross the waters and push your way inside the tower once again. Once inside the room of doors, you soon begin to feel turned around once again. Right. Remember that. In the middle of the floor lies a skeleton. Now, I'm not sure which door is the correct one to go through. Open locks and doors, but which one? Does that take stamina? I'm gonna just cast it, see what happens. You spin the constellations into shape around you. A few doors fly open at random. You catch glimpses of hills, fields, dark chambers and forgotten holes. A snatch of music floats in along with the murmur of whispered voices. Then the door is slammed shut once more. You don't remember really the solution for this, guys. Forgive me. Safe passage. That's, see the future, which you know how longer I have the crystal orb, damn it. Teleportation. Lightning. Resurrect. Talk all languages. Safe passage. You cast a spell. A quiet voice enters your mind. There are many more doors here than there appear. The voice informs you quietly. In fact, all the doors are here, but I will lead you to an exit. With that, the room begins to move into an alignment you can understand. The effect is quite giddy. Okay, I guess we're leaving the chamber at this point. With the aid of the spell, you feel fairly confident of which door is which. Okay. Let's go here then. I guess we're gonna leave. Last time... I don't know if I can replicate, especially now that I cast a spell. When we ended up leaving this tower the first time, we ended up randomly appearing, or apparently randomly appearing, here. I'm pretty sure we were in here. Or right outside it. So I'd like to go back there, but now we've cast a house spell, so... How ironic. Now that I know which door to go through, it doesn't go where I want it to. Let's go here. Guess we're gonna try to get up through mundane means. You enter the tower once more. This is the Chamber of Darkness, but with the Grimalkin in the center broken, there is no magic left here at all. You pick your way carefully but easily through the narrow, clear room. There are two doors from the chamber. Alright, heading this way. You hurry over the stone arch, not looking down. As the sun climbs the sky, the winds rise. You return to the chamber of the two-headed philosopher. The creature in the middle is still arguing with itself, but you slip around it without attracting its attention. You return to the path and walk a short distance. You stop outside the tower, paths snaking this way and that around you. Every path seems weighted down with sadness and oppression. It is not a place to stand still. Now, it looks like this goes inside a tower, but this just goes around them. You step back out onto the path and make your way along it. The sun has reached its highest point now. You stop in the shadow of a large tower to the north. You could explore the tower and move away. We will move away. This is the cat one, isn't it? Oh, right, the statues. Thin heat beats down from an empty sky. You approach the next tower. Okay, so this isn't the statue one. I thought it was way up there. The room you find is full of sealed of statues frozen in various poses. An icy hush fills the air. Is this a gallery of some sort? You step further into the room. There is no furniture, and from the dust it seems no one has been here in a long while. The statues make the room hard to navigate. They cluster and clutter the floor. You make your way across the room looking for a way forwards, and there is one, but a statue blocks it neatly. It has been posed as though racing for the door. The statue in the doorway is of a middle-aged woman. One hand is raised in the air, and her face tilts upward as though she was holding something up and examining an object that is no longer there. The statue is exquisitely done, including fine details such as eyelashes and a lined face. Someone must have labored long on this. The eyes of the statue seem to follow you as you move. Yeah, they're not statues. I just want to leave. You follow the statue's eyeline to a point above the door. Inscribed there is a symbol, too. You grasp the statue and heave, but it does not budge. After a few moments of strain, you step back. But wait, did one of the statues move? Alright. You try again to push the statue, placing your shoulder against it, but you cannot get it to budge. You feel a coldness on your arms. What spell do we want? Cast strength. I mean, whatever it is, I think we found it before, so we can just... I'm clicking on Y. Talk with animals. Summon a giant. Float in the air. That's the seeing the future. Lightning. This unknown thing. Oh, what do we cast? Or did we get stuck here and unable to get past? To the stars, as you craft the magic, a steady voice begins to speak to you. A strange place for a gallery, the voice says. Do not linger. Its message delivered the spell phase. Let's leave by the open door. Screw it. The corpses stare at your back as you leave. Yeesh. Find another way around. You return to the path and follow it a short way. The sun is beginning to lower and the air begins to cool. You stop in the shadow of a large tower to the north. Move on. You can explore the tower and move away. Turned to stone is what I'm looking for. I want to counter that. I think. Pretty sure. I don't think I've ever used this spell. I'm not sure. I think I might have used it once. And it meant that whatever was fighting me could only hit me like every other round or something like that. Illusion of treasure, magic. That I'd like to cast. Protection from magic. That helps in a variety of situations, but nope. It's not an option. This I've never used, because I don't think I've ever found nose plugs. I guess I lost my goldback mirror at some point. Oh, I guess we never countered that. We want to counter this spell, rock. I guess I should avoid that. Maybe I never got past him. Alright, let's avoid. Let's go the east pass, see if we can find a way around somewhere else. Probably not. Is this the statue one, or is it the, I think it's the next one. Okay. The wind picks up as the evening draws on. It will be dark soon. You follow the path and make your way into the tower once more. You move carefully, avoiding the center of the floor where the pit opened up before. Thankfully, there is enough space around the outside of the pit to edge carefully around. So we'll go here. Stop growling at me. Whatever the hell you are. You run over to the tower before the wind can snatch you away. The sun lowers towards the horizon. Soon it'll be dark once more. The chamber inside is as peaceful as before. There is nothing stopping you from moving on in any direction, but as soon as you step outside, you feel the clouds of Mampang gathering overhead once more. There's a path to the south, but it has crumbled into ruin a short way along. A walkway leads off to the east. We're almost out of here. You return to the tower to find that the shield around it has returned. There's no way forward then. The shield blocks the path completely. Oh, great. Great. Oh. I have to dispel that then, if I can. You turn away from the force field and step off the path into the water. Oh really, this has never happened before. Ready to pace around its perimeter. A pace further and you tumble, almost up to your waist in water. It is suddenly very deep. Swim? Throwing yourself into the water, you start to try and swim, but the water seems to have a suction to it. You are being dragged downwards. Right, step back? And we lost some stamina. You turn back and struggle through the thick, turgid water to the path. Moments out of the water and you seem to be dry once more. Casting a spell. Possible. Protection from magic. Oh no. You don't have that option. Create quicksand? Yeah, and then try to swim through the quicksand, yeah. How or fireball? Lightning bolt. Sharpen blade. MHZR. Okay, I don't see anything useful. Move on. Oh, the shield blocks the path. Okay. Oh crap, they make you walk back and forth. Sleep here? Oh, okay. Another night begins. You need to rest, especially on an empty stomach. You approach the tower once again. The chamber inside is as peaceful as before. Setting down your pack, you try to stretch out despite the wind. You have eaten nothing today, but your pack is empty and you cannot eat. Get comfortable and rest. You feel quite safe here and you do not dream. During the past day, you found no new call clues and the Archmage is still waiting for you. We're in the Tower of Calm. I didn't know that. You wake feeling refreshed and calm. Nothing in this protected space has changed. Yeah. Shielding. Counters Zen. Not sure what Zen does. I don't think it's related though. Counters. I need these spells. Hold on. Let's see if I can reach this. It's behind me. So I don't have to flip back and forth. Alright, got it. What does Doc do? Doc. It's about I can memorize this stuff. Doc. I don't even see Doc on here. Must have missed it somehow. Dog? How odd. What the hell is Doc? This is annoying me. Okay. Cure light wounds. Okay. The way I wrote it looks like dog. Let me fix that. Sorry guys, and try to dispel. Ech. Alright, so we've been there. Sharpen blade, we cannot even cast that. Create quicksand. Oh, what does it do? It counters Foff. Foff is, force field. You move the starlight into order around you. Once again, the tower vanishes. The tower is now open for you to return to. There's now nothing to stop you going inside the tower, correct? I really just want to pass through here. The inside of the tower is Spartan. In the middle sits a table on which a piece of paper lies. A pile of yellow sand is scattered around the table's feet. There's nothing to keep you here. Alright, we're going. The path between crumbling towers and dagger-like buttresses. Oh, winds between them. The air stirs a little, still cold but fresh. Another junction. A low tower to the west is set into the wall of the citadel. The shimmering tower blocks your way north. The air around you seems fetid and mean. Which route will you choose? You follow the path step by step. A few clouds move across the sky. The path splits here. Several ways present themselves to you. You follow the path above the water to the crumbled wall. The silence beyond the wall contrasts with the bustle of the city, so we are returning. Did we hear this conversation before? The path leads back towards the hubbub of the city. As the morning moves on, the wind begins to rise. Standing just off the path, you are two laborers. You see them leaning on their shovels next to the pit. I still don't understand the shorter one is saying. I think they're talking about the wizard, the Archmage. Yeah, I remember them. We've dealt with them before. Just gonna continue. There's no time to waste. Although, Lord knows I've... wasted a lot of it. Time to continue. Place is still cold. Alright, we want him to head up. It'll be night soon. Already? Damn. I guess we've never been up this road. Right. We were never able to pass this gate, I'm pretty sure. So, we've never encountered this road before. So this is bound to be interesting. You walk across the square towards the paved lane on the north side. Unlike most of the roads in Manpeng, it is clean and sparsely populated. It curves around the mountain on which the Archmage's Tower stands, climbing slowly. A few yards from the square, a group of guards blocks the road. They stand, sharp and to attention, sheltering in the shade of a nearby hut. Two of them hold snarling dogs on chains. You take a moment to regard the tower, unable to repress a shiver. It stands on the leveled peak of the mountain into which Manpeng is built. At its very top is a tiny turret room which must have a view across the entirety of High Zeeman. You've been there twice already. The road is wide and clear, with the rising rock on one side and a drop on the other. There are no places to hide. One of the guards spies you and stamps forward. The nearest comes out to greet you with a growl. "Well?" the guard snaps. "Where does this road lead?" "I know full well where it leads." "You what?" "The inner fortress. Can't you see it?" "Why are there so many guards?" you ask. "To stop the likes of you from coming past," she replies stubbornly. "May I pass?" "Not a chance. Only guards up here, and they have to... have some business as well. Try going past me, and I will skewer you myself, however nicely we rub along," she grins. "This chattering is getting on my nerves," she growls. "No civilians allowed. Back off." The guard crosses her arms, scowling at you. The other guards mill about nearby. So I can barge past her, draw my sword, and have at thee, or cast some kind of spell. Sharpened blade we can't use. Illusion of worship. Control non-intelligent creatures. Well, they're intelligent. At least, presumably so. Cause stupidity. So we got... we got... illusion of worship. Stupidity. Fireball. Did I do this one? God. Yeah. Oops. Create illusions. Yeah. Alright, so, a feeling barging past her is about the same as drawing your sword. Either one, you end up in a battle. Don't know if I want to battle them, right? A group of guards. Yeah, I'll have to fight a group of guards. Okay, so the choices are going to be cast Illusion of Worship, cast Stupidity, or cast Fireball. So if hopefully I remember and put them on the side here. Illusion of Worship, Stupidity, or Fireball. Those will be the only choices I accept. Of course, you can ruminate on others, but yeah, those are the three we have to do to deal with. And yeah, hopefully next episode, back into the Archmage's Tower for, I don't know, what might be the last episode? I don't know. Because now we have the key to that place. We have the key to the cell, don't we? The cell key. The key to the mini-mite cell. So we can either retrieve the mini-mite, or get out without using having to use the mini-mite, or throw the mini-mite away, or something like that. I think the mini-mite might be the secret, maybe, to defeating the Archmage, because remove the magic, and he's just a normal person, right? That'll be including the Crown of Kings. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Let me know which of these spells I should cast. And as always, thanks for watching and endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week.